Hey, welcome back to All About That Disney Life. I am Danny B, the girl who is all about that Disney life. We now move on to our next attraction for Epcot. It is Soarin, which is located at the World Nature section of the park. So here's a little bit of a backstory to this attraction. This is a flight motion simulator attraction at Disney California Adventure, Epcot, Shanghai Disneyland, and Tokyo DisneySea. It employs a mechanical lift system, a projected presentation on an 80-foot concave, 180-degree dome screen, and artificial scents and wind to simulate a hang gliding flight over locations in six of the world's continents. Many actually consider this the first flying theater. The attraction's first version, Soarin over California, was an opening day attraction at Disney California Adventure, which opened on February 8, 2001. It took guests over several locations in California and included a pre-show on the history of California's aviation industry. It was also installed at Epcot at Walt Disney World as Soarin in 2005. The current global version of the ride debuted at Shanghai Disneyland Park as Soarin over the Horizon on June 16, 2016. The American versions were also replaced with the new movie as Soarin Around the World, which came out on June 17, 2016. A fourth version of the attraction called Soaring Fantastic Flight, it opened at Tokyo DisneySea on July 23, 2019. The original Soarin over California has been in regular rotations at Disney California Adventure since an initial limited engagement in June of 2019, and its popularity led Disney to extend the run through the end of August of that year. Since 2010, Soarin over California has returned in continuous temporary operations as part of the park's food and wine festival during the months of the season of spring. So let's move on to the ride design for the attraction. This idea was first conceptualized in 1996 as Ultraflight, a name that can still be seen on the tower consoles of the California Adventure attraction. It was to feature an OmniMax screen with an inverted track allowing guests to fly over California's landmarks. It was to have three low levels with a system operating on a horizontal cable, much like a dry cleaner's rack. The plan was abandoned when it was determined that the design's construction and labor costs would be prohibitive. It seemed that Soarin wouldn't become a reality until engineer Mark Summer developed a different idea for the ride vehicles using an erector set and string to create a working model. The new design allowed Disney to efficiently load guests on one level instead of three, significantly cutting its building costs. Each ride vehicle consists of three rows of seats under a wing-like canopy with a capacity of 87 guests. After guests have been safely restrained in the vehicle with standard lap belts, the canopy descends slightly and a cantilever system lifts the chairs forward and into the air with the guests' feet dangling freely. The vehicle is lifted forward so that guests look into a large concave movie screen onto which aerial views are projected. The original movie scenes were shot at an IMAX HD frame rate of 48 frames per second, twice the conventional rate of regular movies. The vehicle is moved forward toward the center of the dome so guests can see only the projected images and experience the sensation of flight. The ride structure contains about 1 million pounds of steel. 37 tons are lifted during each ride cycle. To enhance the illusion, subtle vertical movements of the seats are synchronized to the movie. Sensations of horizontal motion are created with a combination of vertical carriage movement and turning the image on the screen. Scents complementing the scenes are also injected into the air by streams blowing on the riders. When it opened, the scent was only present during the Redwood Creek scene and the Valencia Orange Farm scenes. In the updated show, scents include rose blossoms in the Taj Mahal scene, grass in the Africa scene, and a sea breeze in the South Pacific scene. So let's talk about the different versions at each of the four parks. We will start off with the Disney California Adventure version. Soarin' Around the World is in Grizzly Peak Airfield section of Disney California Adventure at Disneyland Resort. This attraction is Disneyland's most popular attraction and it utilizes the park's Genie Plus system, allowing guests to reserve specific ride times to avoid long queues. While in line, guests pass the Wings of Fame, an homage to Disney's aviation history, including profiles of the P-51 Mustang, SR-71 Blackbird, and Bell X-1. There is also a section dedicated to aviators, such as John J. Montgomery, Amelia Earhart, Jimmy Doolittle, Charles Lindbergh, Jack Northrop, the Wright Brothers, Howard Hughes, Jacqueline Cochran, Kelly Johnson, Paul McCready, and Chuck Yeager. Inspirational music from a variety of aviation-related movies is played in the queue areas, including Patton, MacArthur, Air Force One, The Blue Max, Explorers, The American President, Dragonheart, Dragon, The Bruce Lee Story, Angels in the Outfield, The Last Starfighter, Apollo 13, The Rocketeer, Always, and the HBO miniseries Band of Brothers. The Air Force song and Jupiter from Gustav Holst's orchestral suite, The Planets, are also heard based on their use in The Right Stuff. Before entering the theater area, guests are placed in one of three pre-show areas called Alpha Gate, Bravo Gate, and Charlie Gate. Those are the three letters for the NATO phonetic alphabet. Just before boarding, guests see a pre-boarding video hosted by their chief flight attendant, Patrick Warburton. The attraction opened with the park in 2001 as Soarin Over California in what was then the park's Condor Flats area. In early 2015, it closed for refurbishment as the surrounding area was transformed into Grizzly Peak Airfield. It reopened on May 15, 2015 with new exterior theming and updates to its screen and projection system. It now utilizes a laser-illuminated digital projection array, replacing its original IMAX systems. Several exterior changes include the replacement of the mock-up RS-25 rocket engine with a fire lookout tower. From January to March of 2016, the attraction intermittently operated as Soarin' Over California to prepare for the introduction of the new Soarin' Around the World ride movie. The original movie was shown until June 16th, when the attraction was closed to prepare for the new film's debut on June 17th. Since Soarin' Around the World's opening on June 17th, 2016, visitors to Disney California Adventure are usually able to find Soarin' Around the World playing. However, on various occasions, Disney has brought back the original Soarin' Over California for return engagements. The first one was on May 23rd, 2019. Disney announced that Soarin' Over California would temporarily return to the park for the month of June, following the opening of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Disneyland on May 31st. On June 21st, they announced that the limited return had been extended to August 31st, 2019 due to popular demand. On February 28th, 2020, the California version of the ride returned to California Adventure for the Disney California Adventure Food and Wine Festival. The limited engagement was scheduled to run through April 21st, but ended prematurely when the resort began its extended closure due to the COVID-19 pandemic on March 13th. When the resort reopened on April 30th, 2021, Soarin' Around the World was being shown. The following year, the California version began its annual temporary return for the duration of the Food and Wine Festival. Let's move on to the version of Soarin' at Epcot. The attraction was duplicated simply as Soarin' and officially opened inside the Land Pavilion at Epcot at Walt Disney World on May 5th, 2005, along with Lights, Motors, Action, Extreme Stunt Show at Disney's Hollywood Studios as part of the Happiest Celebration on Earth Festival. Unlike the Disney California Adventure version, this show had guests taking flights to California. The concept was reintroduced with theming of guests being loaded into gates, with airport-themed spiels referring to Flight 5505, an homage to the attraction's opening day. Cast members wear costumes resembling flight attendant uniforms, whereas the California version wear airfield crew uniforms. The Epcot queue originally had pictures of natural wonders from around the world, not just California. It utilized a new infrared technology that allows guests to participate in interactive games. In 2009, this interactive technology appeared at Magic Kingdom as part of a 7-month overhaul of Space Mountain. These interactive games were replaced with the Soarin' Challenge, a team-based game of trivia with questions pertaining to geography, landmarks, and cultures. Guests utilized displays throughout the queue and the Companion Play Disney Parks smartphone app to join one of four color teams and help their team achieve the highest score by answering questions correctly and quickly. The attraction closed for refurbishment on January 4th, 2016, and was originally slated to reopen on June 17th, with a third theater to coincide with the release of the new Soarin' Around the World movie. The ride reopened with the original movie on May 27th, and the change to the new movie occurred on June 17th, 2016. Disney announced that Soarin' Over California would temporarily return in the park on September 22nd, 2023, as part of Disney's 100 Years of Wonder celebration. This return run ended on February 27th, 2024, and Soarin' Around the World has returned. So let's move on to the version of Soarin' at Shanghai Disneyland. The attraction was retooled as Soarin' Over the Horizon for Shanghai Disneyland Park. It was not part of the park's original plan, but was added to it after Walt Disney Imagineering began developing similar attractions for the U.S. parks. It's located in the park's Adventure Isle area, and it opened with the park on June 16, 2016. Embedded in the Adventure Isle setting, the attraction is presented as an ancient observatory and temple to the Arborees tribe condor god. The pre-show and safety spiel are hosted by a shaman of the tribe who grants guests the ability of flight, but has trouble controlling her own shape-shifting abilities. And finally, there is the fourth version of Soarin at Tokyo Disney Sea. On April 27, 2016, Tokyo Disney Resort announced a number of coming attractions for Tokyo Disneyland and Tokyo Disney Sea parks, including a proposed version of Soarin, which was titled Soarin Fantastic Flight. It was to be in the Mediterranean Harbor section of Tokyo Disney Sea. The announcement said this version would have a different theme, with ride vehicles designed as Renaissance-era dream flyers created by Aviatrix and Society of Explorers and Adventurers member Camila Falco. This ride opened on July 23, 2019. In this version of the attraction, rather than an aviation terminal, it is set in the Museum of Fantastic Flight, which is hosting a retrospective on the life of Camila Falco. Her spirit takes guests to see some of her dream flyer gliders and invites them on a flight of fantasy around the world. Two other differences can be seen in this version of the movie. The Paris scene is replaced with Tokyo at sunset with Mount Fuji in the background, and the finale is a flight over Tokyo Disney Sea. So I have been talking about the ride movies that is associated with the four various versions of Soarin at the Disney parks. Let's talk about the original Soarin movie that is with the attraction Soarin Over California. The original ride movie, which lasts 4 minutes and 51 seconds, it takes guests on a simulated hang glider tour of California. Appropriate scents such as citrus pine, sagebrush, and ocean mist, it fills the air as the ride vehicles move gently to simulate the sensations of flight. In addition to the state's various landscapes, it also highlights its diverse recreation, including skiing, river rafting, kayaking, golf, horseback riding, hot air ballooning, surfing, and of course, hang gliding. The locations for the original Disney Soarin Over California movie, it is the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco, Redwood Creek in Humboldt County, Napa Valley, Monterey Bay Sanctuary, Lake Tahoe and Heavenly Mountain Resort, Yosemite Falls and Half Dome in Yosemite National Park, PGA West Palmer Course in La Quinta, Valencia Orange Groves over unincorporated Ventura County, Enza Borgio Desert State Park, the USS John C. Stennis at Naval Air Station North Island in San Diego, Malibu Beach, Downtown Los Angeles, and Disneyland Resort in Anaheim. The original Soarin Over California ride movie at both Disney California Adventure and Epcot has an orchestral score by Jerry Goldsmith, who is said to have come down from his first ride in tears. In addition to finding it visually beautiful and magical, he said that his father was a pilot who loved all things Californian. His soundtrack plays during the entire attraction, starting with a crescendo in the low strings while the screen is still dark. Numerous variations of a Soarin theme for horn and strings are heard, and several statements of a fanfare accompanies the grandest vistas. The original ride score was included on Disneyland Resort and Walt Disney World official albums, including Walt Disney Records, The Legacy Collection, Disneyland. It continues to be heard as ambient music in the Disneyland Resort Esplanade and Epcot's Entrance Plaza. So Soarin got a new ride movie, as we have been talking about, and they all have different titles. We have Soarin Over the Horizon, Soarin Around the World, and Soarin Fantastic Flight. On August 15, 2015, at the D23 Expo, it was announced that the attractions at Epcot and Disney California Adventure would debut versions of the new Soarin Over the Horizon ride movie, titled Soarin Around the World, featuring locations, landscapes, and landmarks across six continents. Unlike the original movie, the updated version heavily utilizes computer-generated imagery, including animated transitions between scenes, such as close encounters with a seaplane, a kite, and an eagle. The updated attractions opened on June 17, 2016 at Disney California Adventure and Epcot, along with a third theater for the later location. The current movie's locations that are seen on the attraction are the Matterhorn in Switzerland and Italy, Isfjord, Greenland, Port Jackson in Sydney, Australia, Neuschwanstein Castle in Bavaria, Germany, Kilimanjaro National Park and Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania, the Great Wall of China in China, the Great Pyramids in Egypt, Taj Mahal in Uttar Pradesh, India, West and East Mitten Buttes in Monument Valley, Arizona, United States, Lau Islands in Fiji, the Iguazu Falls in Brazil and Argentina. There is the Eiffel Tower in Paris, France, that is seen at the Shanghai Disneyland version, the Disney California Adventure version, and the Epcot version. But at the Tokyo Disney Sea version, we see the Tokyo Tower in Tokyo. Then you also see the Luja Zoo in Shanghai, China, which is shown at the Shanghai Disneyland version. We see Disney California, United States, in the Disney California Adventure version. We see Epcot Florida, United States, at the Epcot version. And we see the Tokyo Disney Sea in Chiba at the Tokyo Disney Sea version. Soarin' Around the World and Soarin' Over the Horizon received a new score by Bruce Broughton, heavily based on Goldsmith's original score, and performed by the London Studio Orchestra. And all versions, except for the Disney California version and Shanghai Disneyland version, have their home park flyover set as the grand finale. So my experience with the ride, I'm not gonna lie, I've only been on this ride one time, and that was in 2021, because let's start off with my history of Epcot. When I first went to Disney World with my mom and my sister in 2016, we only went to Epcot for one day, and we all agreed that that was enough. The next time we went in 2019, we all decided not to go to Epcot anymore because it was just too much, and we didn't find that there was a lot to do, and it was really busy, and you experience Epcot once and that's it, you're done. We only went to Epcot just to go to the Coral Reef restaurant for dinner, and that was it. So I went to Epcot for the day with my husband in 2021 on our honeymoon, and I think this was right after we had our dinner, because we had an early dinner at around 5 o'clock in the late afternoon. So it was we weren't ready to leave the park. It's like, oh, what else can we do? And he said, you want to try out Soarin? And I said, sure, what is it? And he said, it's a flight simulator. You go like hang gliding, like a flight hang gliding, but you're like lifted up into the air, this, that, and the other. And I said, okay, that sounds like a real great experience. So I went on it. I found it very, very enlightening, and it did feel real. Like, it felt like I was hang gliding and seeing all the amazing places that are around the world. And if I ever get back to Disney World, and I hope I get back to Disney World one day, whenever I can afford it, I will definitely head to Epcot just to go on to this ride. But I find the ride very relaxing, and it's in a building. And once again, this is a great attraction to get out of the Florida heat. So those are the facts to Soarin'. If you like this video, please hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe. And I hope you have a zippity-doo-dah day. Goodbye.